Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship today. So if you may recall, Chaplain David is on vacation and he hopefully is traveling the countryside of Berlin right now. And so keep him in your prayers, him and his wife Mary, as they are enjoying this time together. In his stead today, we have Pastor Alex Schrader, who is from Immanuel Olivette, and happens to also be a good friend of Chaplain David Corson. So we are blessed to have him here leading us today in worship. Today is going to be a little bit of a different kind of worship than what we normally do, and of course you would expect that because we have this lovely group of 7th and 8th graders here. And I'm going to hand it over to you. I get to go sit in the back today, and this is the man in charge, so welcome.
Well, thank you so much, Corinne. It's a delight to be here, and thank you all for coming. And we're certainly just thankful for God's presence here in this place.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And so before we begin, we'd love to have a short little introduction from our students who are here this morning. So class, I can call you class, even though you're classes. Let's stand, and if you could, we're just gonna do this a little ad hoc, but you can come up this way, and I'll preview the microphone, and you can just say your name and what grade you're in, and just say something special about you and just your, just tell us about who you are. Just a couple of seconds, yeah.
Hi, I'm Annalise Dunbar, and I'm in eighth grade.
I'm Sydney French, and I'm in eighth grade.
I'm Charles Turnow, I'm in seventh grade.
I'm Elliot Willerton, and I'm in seventh grade.
I'm Beatrice Brick, and I'm in eighth grade.
I'm Gabriella Reitler, and I'm in seventh grade.
I'm Grace Mertzloft, and I'm in 8th grade.
I'm Bria Redman, and I'm in 8th grade.
Hi, I'm Hobie, and I'm in 7th grade.
I'm Marcus Penny, I'm in 7th grade.
Yeah, well, thank you all. So you can feel free to put that microphone back in there and head back to your seats. So again, we're just blessed and thankful to be here with you. And let's make our beginning this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we'll begin our service in prayer this morning. So we pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your amazing blessings. We thank you that you have made salvation so easily attainable for us by the fact that you died on the cross and you rose from the grave for us. And you are our good shepherd. And we hear about that this morning, that we as sheep need a shepherd desperately, and you have come and done that for us, and we are very thankful. And we thank you for the relationships that you've given to us and all the wonderful blessings. And as we contemplate coming up to receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus, we thank you for your blessing of being here in that as well. We love you, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is Crown Him with Many Crowns. So who knows this song, Crown Him with Many Crowns? Okay, good, we are among friends. That's a good thing. And if you haven't heard it, hopefully this is something that you can catch on to and enjoy. So feel free to take a look at the music up front, and we'll sing together.
Awake my soul.
voices. What a blessing. So again, I know we did this before, but there's no harm in doing it again. We make our beginning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Sing to the Lord a new song.
For he has done marvelous things.
In the name of God the Father.
Praise to our redeeming God.
In the name of his Son Jesus.
Praise to our redeeming God.
Let us join our thankful voices.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Now we go through our confession this morning, our confession of sins, to receive forgiveness as we prepare our hearts and minds to receive the body and blood of our Lord as well. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins unto God our Father, beseeching him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
I said, I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord.
And you forgave the iniquity of my sin.
O Almighty God, merciful Father,
I, the poor, miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserve your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them, and I pray to you for all causes of mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, and their sufferings and death, your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious to me, a poor, sinful being.
Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I announce the grace of God unto all of you. And in the stead, by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, merciful Father, since you have wakened from death the shepherd of your sheep, grant us your Holy Spirit, that when we hear the voice of our shepherd, we may know him who calls us each by name, and follow where he leads, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We continue with our next hymn, and following our hymn will be our readings. But our next hymn is Christ, the Life of All the Living.
Crucifixion, holy to us.
And as they were speaking to the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them, greatly annoyed because they were teaching the people and proclaiming in Jesus the resurrection from the dead. And they arrested them and put them in custody until the next day, for it was already evening. But many of those who had heard the word believed, and the number of the men who came up to about 5,000. On the next day, the rulers and elders and scribes gathered together in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest and Caiaphas and John and Alexander and all who were of the high priestly family. And when they had set them in the midst, they inquired, "By what power or by what name did you do this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are being examined today concerning a good deed done to a crippled man, by what means this man has been healed, let it be known to all of you and to all people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man is standing before you well. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved."
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from 1 John 3, verse 16 to 24. "By this we know love, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brothers. But if anyone has the world's goods and sees his brother in need, yet closes his heart against him, how does God's love abide in him? Little children, let us not love in word or talk, but in deed and in truth. By this we shall know that we are of the truth and reassure our heart before him. For whenever our heart condemns us, God is greater than our heart, and he knows everything. Beloved, if our heart does not condemn us, we have confidence before God. And whatever we ask, we receive from him, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And this is his commandment, that we believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he has commanded us. Whoever keeps his commandments abides in God, and God in him. And by this we know that he abides in us, by the Spirit whom he has given us."
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you so much for speaking. And while our team is coming up for our first song, I just wanted to share just our thanks of being able to be here with you. Just again, and as we hear the word of the Lord this morning, we remember just how wonderful and pleasant it is for the word of God to be on the lips of all people, to be on the lips of all people, to be sharing that with others. And we look forward, as we heard in 1 John, to this glorious day that God has for us, that he has prepared an amazing moment for us when we see him face to face. And the beautiful thing about being a Christian is that tomorrow is always a new day. And yesterday is never better than what we have in front of us, ever. So this is the gift and the wonderful blessing and promise that God has for us. So we hear about that a little bit today as we see it performed for us in song. I'm wondering if we're having a conflict with the HDMI cord. One moment. Thank you for your time.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men. Example is he. The word became flesh, and the light shined among us. His glory revealed. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried me. suffering angry, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is here. Hands that heal nations, stretched out on a tree, took the nails for me.
We give all praise and thanks and honor and glory to our Lord Jesus, who has done all of these things. Our next readings we have come from John 10. We actually have two portions of the gospel here this morning, John 10 and Luke 19.
A reading from John 10, verses 11 through 18. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is hired hand and not a shepherd, who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father.
This is the
Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
A reading from Luke 19, verse 37 through 40. As he was drawing near, already on the way down the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of his disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." And some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the very stones would cry out."
This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, O Christ.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead, and he ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Our sermon hymn for today, our hymn before our message, is Beautiful Savior. To you a little about Well, we have four verses today, and I'd like to touch on all of them. I'd like to touch on all of them just a little bit, these four verses. But before I do, I wanted to share with you, when I knew your chaplain, David Corson, what do you refer to him as? Do you call him chaplain?
Chaplain.
Chap? Did I hear chap? Or chaplain?
Chaplain.
Okay. Because he's a goofy guy. It wouldn't surprise me if he went by chap. But when I knew him back in the day, my daughter was maybe 3 years old. And chaplain was actually at Crave Coffee House, which is Christ in the City Lutheran Church, if you guys remember, if you're familiar with that. It's a mission to the St. Louis University student campus. And so my daughter and I would go there all the time because it was a great place where we could just kind of restore ourselves and just feel kind of at peace. And during the worship service, they would take these little cards where you could fill out this card and you could say, "Thank you, Lord, for," or something to pray for. And so my daughter wrote on there, "Thank you, Lord, for chocolate muffins." Because she loved chocolate muffins. And you could get them at that time, you could get them at Crave quite frequently. So she would do that, and I have a few pictures of her, quite messy. But for whatever reason, when Chaplin read this, it struck him, and he continued to bring that up on how my daughter just found that to be such a delightful thing. And he says, when he was up there, he said, "This is it. This is what it's all about. Loving chocolate muffins," just in other words, the little things that God would do for us. And I'm not kidding you, I don't always eat chocolate muffins, okay? But I love them. I would if they were put in front of me. But my wife is so sweet. She packs me a lunch and sometimes breakfast in the mornings when we're both able. You know, it's hit and miss if we can't. But no joke, this morning I opened it and look what I found inside. A chocolate muffin. I can't believe it. So I've been holding off on eating this just to show you the proof that it happened. But I wanted to share that because this was kind of the beginning of, first of all, just my friendship with Chaplin, and also just my daughter's kind of upbringing and beginning to understand what Jesus was all about. And I think she really found Jesus in that place. And places are really important, I think, with how God does this, on how God comes to us and how he opens up his faith to us. And we hear that a little bit in our passages this morning. But I have one other show-and-tell thing to show you. So my daughter, do you know those little fuzzy flowers that you can get at, like, the dollar store? And they've got that little wire inside, and they're colorful? Well, I have one with me. I guess I didn't need to explain it. I could have just showed you. But every year for my daughter's birthday, you guys know these?
Yeah.
Do these look familiar? Good. Okay. Every year for my daughter's birthday, since she was 2 or 3, she would always get one of these from me. So it was just kind of a thing for her. And I remember when she was 7 or 8, you know, when it started to make sense to her that every year she would get one of these flowers. But it was not about her getting a flower. It was about her remembering the relationship and the love that we had between each other every time she would open this. And I remember when she was 7 or 8 and she opened it, she just burst into tears and ran over to me and just wrapped her arms around me and cried when she opened her flower. Same flower she got the year before, same flower she got the year before that, but she started to understand what it meant. And so every year since then, she's always had one of these from me on her birthday. But there was one birthday, I think it was her 16th or 18th, I don't know where I found it, but I found one of these that was literally like that big. And it had the head that was this big, and I gave it to her, and she was floored by that one. But even now, she still gets these. And she just turned 21 this year. And so I thought to myself, and guess what, she got a red one this year, but I thought to myself and wondered, maybe this is the last time I'm giving her a flower as my dependent, you know, as my daughter, as one in my household as she's turning 21. Because the day is coming where I am ushering her into a life of her own. I will never stop giving these to her. That's just part of our nature, but it does kind of help us think of how God continues to, you know, shape us and grow us as his children, and we continue year after year to get older and to learn more and get a little wiser, and finally God has a vocation planned for each one of us, and a place to go for each one of us. Now, I've kind of bounced around, I've talked about, they all tie in together, they all tie into our verses. I've bounced around, I've talked about relationships, I've talked about places, we've talked about the ways in which we show our love and see this from what God does to us. But I want to go to the reading from, it was 1 John 3. I love this so much, and I hope that you embrace this, these words with me, because they're so deep and rich. But it says, John writes here, "By this we know love, that he laid down his life for us. Is there any love greater than laying your life down for someone? That we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. But if anyone has the world's goods and sees his brother in need and yet closes his heart against him, how does God's love abide in him if we hold it to ourselves? Little children, let us not love in word or talk only, but also in deed and truth. By this, we shall know that we are all of the truth and treasure our heart before him. For whenever our heart condemns us, God is greater than our heart, and he knows everything." Now here's the part I wanted to focus on. Beloved, our heart does not condemn us if we have confidence before God. And whatever we ask and receive from him, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. We hear that and we say, oh, well, I don't know about you, but when I look at my life and I compare it to what the commandments say I'm supposed to do, I'm not doing so hot. What about you? You feel that way too? You guys? We're not doing so hot when we compare our lives to what the commandments say. But here's the blessing, and that the commandments are all wrapped up in this. Because he says, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And he says, and this is his commandment. That we believe in the name of his son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us. That is the commandments wrapped into one. So when it says here that we do his commandments, it means we are doing the love. We are loving one another. We are sharing with one another. And most importantly, that we, as he says, we believe in the name of his son, Jesus Christ. And because of that, we have a glorious day in front of us. Maybe I'll say that louder. We have a glorious day in front of us. Okay, maybe? We have a glorious day in front of us. Oh, I love it. Whoever keeps his commandments abides in God, and God is in him. As we know, they will know we are Christians by our love. And by this, we know that he abides in us by the Spirit of whom he has given us. So we thank you for showing your love to us that we are here. And we thank you for the love that you have shown to so many around you. The fact that you're here shows your love for Jesus. The fact that you care for each other shows your love for each other. And the mere fact that we're all together shows that we are a community of God's people who get to love him and be loved by him and have our promise played out. And we get to watch it in front of our very eyes that he has done this for us. Praise be to him. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you that you gave up all things to come to earth, that you gave up your glory and your majesty, that the one who made the stars and the heavens and created the trees and the birds and the rivers and the fish, the one who made my heart and started it to beat, the one who gave me breath and caused me to breathe. Each morning we wake up and we see the greatness of your wonders. And you have done these things and you humbled yourself. You gave it all up so that you could save us when we failed you. Lord, we thank you that you, your entire inheritance and your glory, you have shared with us, that we can partake in your love as your children. Lord, your great victory that you have done for us on the cross, we thank and praise you as we celebrate your Easter Sunday every day of our lives. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you all. And with that, the peace of God which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. As our team comes up for our next presentation here for you at the Stick Ministry, Just again, wanted to give you thanks. And my wife, Vicky, did want me to share her greetings with you and wish she could be here as well. But we're actually getting ready for a trip as chaplains on a trip. We may be swapping. Maybe we'll pass each other on the road. Who knows? But again, just those greetings to you and thank you so much. Let me pull this up here and make sure that I am in good shape.
Thank you.
table. Thank you so much. We praise the one who has given us this inheritance, this promise. So we continue with our prayers. Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Shepherd of Israel, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have sought out your sheep and gathered us into your flock. Keep us always in your fold and grant us, guard us from every wolf and snare. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, you alone gather us as your sheep and send faithful servants out to us. Call all who have wandered from your flock and bless the faithful shepherds who gather them through the voice of your word. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your Son has called us to love our brothers. Turn us in love toward the neighbors closest to us, especially within our own homes, that we may daily show our confidence in God by deed and truth, laying down our lives as Christ first did for us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Eternal Lord, through the Paschal Lamb, you have wrought peace between man and God. By your gift of good government, grant peace and good days also to our citizens and between the nations of the world, that we and all of our neighbors may lead quiet lives in godly contentment. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, by the first fruits of Christ's life from the dead, you secured forgiveness for our troubled consciences. Bless also with temporal health and well-being those who suffer among us, especially Karen, Vi, Bob, Jillian, Vi, Phil, Shirley, Dodie, Maggie, and all those on our hearts. We give thanks for the life of James Wilson and ask for comfort to be given to all who grieve his passing. Grant them aid in this moment and, even more so, true immortal health in the world to come. Lord, in your mercy. O Lord, our shepherd, you calm all fears in this valley of the shadow of death. And you prepare the holy table of your Son's testament for us in the presence of our enemies. Grant us repentant and faithful hearts. In every tribulation or besetting sin, lead us to find comfort and strength in your overflowing mercy given to us here in this sacrament. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, out of your fatherly goodness, you have remembered us poor, miserable sinners and given your beloved Son to be our shepherd, not only to nourish us by his word, but also to defend us from sin, death, and the devil. Grant us your Holy Spirit, that even as this shepherd knows us and helps in every affliction, we also may know him, trust him, seek comfort and help in him, heartily obey his voice, and obtain eternal salvation. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We pray together the prayer that our Lord has taught us. Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power,
the Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And most especially we are bound to praise you on this day for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, the very Paschal Lamb, who was sacrificed for us and bore our sins of the world. By his dying, he has destroyed death, and by his rising again, he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with Mary Magdalene, Peter, and John, and with all the witnesses of the resurrection, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ. On the night when he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and he gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to all of them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and we drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. I hope you're not reading that right across my chest. The Lord's Supper is for baptized Christians who know that they are sinners saved by grace through faith in Jesus Christ alone. We believe and teach that the words of Jesus, "This is my body and this is my blood," promise that he is truly present in, with, and under the bread and wine off which we are offering to you and Jesus offers to you for the forgiveness of your sins. This is not just what you believe, but we invite you to cross your arms. I'm sorry, let me refrain. If this is not what you believe, we invite you to cross your arms if you come forward, and then you will receive a blessing. And if you stay seated, we will share the Father's blessing with you as we pass by. If you have questions concerning this practice or any part of the worship service, we encourage you to please speak with the chaplain or myself, who is standing in his place. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world.
Grant us peace.
We pray. We thank you, Lord, that you have blessed us and strengthened us through this salutary gift. And we implore you of your mercy that you would strengthen us through the same, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. In your name we pray. Amen. And receive now the blessing and benediction of our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. Amen. We pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, you have given us a foretaste of the feast to come in the Holy Supper of your Son's body and blood. Keep us firm in the true faith throughout our days of pilgrimage that, on the day of his coming, we may together with all your saints celebrate the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
And I did just give you a blessing and benediction. So we will end with our closing prayer, our closing hymn, excuse me, "From All That Dwell Below the Skies." And my eyesight's getting weaker as I am trying to stare at this. So if you can sing out, maybe I'll follow you a little bit too. So thanks. Here we go.
"From all that dwell below the skies, let the Creator's praise arise. Alleluia, alleluia. Let the Redeemer's day be sung. Through every land, by every tongue.
here with you. And just thanks, and we'll stick around for a little bit to get the chance to chat with you, and maybe we can get to know each other a little bit before we head out this morning. But again, thank you so much, and great, I'll pass it on over to you.
Thank you. We have our closing announcements, and then we've had a request for you to make one final introduction.
Oh.
So we have a young lady over here who has helped to lead and bring your youth into such synchronicity, and what an incredible and beautiful presentation. Could you please take a moment and introduce your leader over here?
Thank you so much. How wonderful of you to do that. How silly of me to overlook that. But this is Miss Henty. Miss Henty's our seventh grade teacher, and she's
good morning. It's really nice to be here with you today. My name is Brenda Henty, and I am the seventh grade teacher at Immanuel Lutheran in Olivette, and I have the special privilege of working with these nine children over here, and then one over there, makes 10. Two times a week, for about a half an hour, we practice our songs with our sticks. Now, this is something fairly new that we started just maybe a year ago, but this year even more so than last year. And it's a pleasure to be here with you to share in God's love and our messages through our song and our step ministry.
That's wonderful.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here.
Okay, our closing announcements are very simple today. This coming Monday, we will have Bible study in the assisted living at 11 a.m. and then the co-ed Bible study at 2 p.m. in the club room. These are regularly scheduled Bible studies. There is one small change. The independent living Bible study that is the co-ed at 2 p.m. is going to be led on Monday by Joel Christensen. He's going to be stepping in to fill in for Chaplain David while he's on vacation. And the topic for Monday is going to be the Good Shepherd. So John 10, so you're going to get a double dose. Can never get enough Jesus. The other announcement that I have is Thursday morning, tomorrow morning, is going to be 9 a.m. Women's Bible Study in the theater. We'll continue our topic on the women of the New Testament, and so I invite you to come and join us. That's at 9 a.m. That's all of our announcements. Pastor Schrader, thank you so much. You have been a blessing to us, and thank you to all of you in using your talent and your hearts and your spiritual gifts to be able to come and worship with us and lead us today. You were amazing, and we look forward to having you back again. Thank you. Go in peace and serve your Lord, and take a moment, if you're able to come and greet these fine young minds.
Good to see you.